Hi, this is Kavita Sanghvi from CNM School and NT Parakvi Primary School, Mumbai, India. So we are a K-12 school catering to more than 3,200 students. At CNM School, the vision is to facilitate holistic learning, building character, and developing skills to meet the global challenges. We strive to ensure that we are reaching every student through varied academic, curricular, and co-curricular activities like sports, dance, music, yoga, martial arts, and art and craft. In fact, we've created our own in-house team curricula, but very often the challenge that we face is how do you measure that skills and holistic development in the students? Yes, we do have our board exams which speak of academic success, but values, skills, overall personality development is one major concern. And we are a school which is more than 20 years old. So we decided that we need to have a third agency evaluate us so that we can celebrate our strengths and work on our shortcomings. Last year, we went for two agencies for accreditation and certification. The first agency was NABET, National Board of Education and Training, from Quality Council of India, headed by the Prime Minister of India. Now they conduct two visits. First is a readiness visit, which understands how ready are you for the final visit. And the final visit where they evaluate you on 50 parameters to understand if you're anywhere close to your quality objectives. And they interview every stakeholder both within and outside the organization to get a 360 degree perspective. I'm very happy to share that we started this process in the month of October 2019. And in the month of January 2020, we had a readiness visit. We had a lot of red marks because we had realized that, you know, there are many areas where documentation was required. So we all worked very, very hard. And in the month of March, we had a final visit. And we received the accreditation in month of May 2020. The second certification we wanted was the International Dimension in School Certificate from British Council, which measures international mindedness and global awareness in our students. So we began the process in May 2019. And in around June 2020, we had to submit it, but because of lockdown, we ended up submitting in October 2020. And in January 2021, the first Jan itself, we received the certification. So extremely, extremely happy to say that we successfully attained both of them and we received constructive feedback on the way forward to improve our processes. And this I owe it to the entire team of teachers and students. Now, what a couple of things that has happened across this entire year. We're school catering to more than 3,200 students. And with the lockdown, we had to shift the entire huge population to online teaching and learning. And the journey did have hiccups. We began experimenting with a lot of online assessments also, moving back and forth from Google Forms, MS Forms to ExamNet. So we started initially with one camera, we moved on and we noticed the students were cheating. So we moved on to two cameras. As we saw students' academic performance shoot up by 20-30%. And it was really unnerving. Someone who struggled with maths concept, suddenly you find the child scoring full marks. And you know that there has been some kind of a foul play. And we did have countless meetings with students and parents to ensure and sustain academic honesty. But somewhere we have been unsuccessful. You know, people, currently the students are enjoying a very, very strong academic report. And my biggest obstacle to counter this problem are the government regulations that have said, you know, the schools cannot reopen. Because unless we have an offline evaluation, we will not be able to compare the marks to the online and help to fill in the concept gaps and misunderstandings. Nevertheless, this year has offered immense learning, and I never ever felt that we would be able to hone our technological skills so sharply. Like in the month of May, we honestly were clueless how to reach out to our students. We did have a Facebook page, we did have a school website, we did have a school portal, and we did use free Zoom links. But we realized in the free Zoom links, the students were much smarter than us. They actually knew how to control us. So what we did at that time is, we spoke to a lot of fellow organizations, we spoke to educators across the country, and international. We joined organizations like the Indian Principles Network to understand what other principals are doing. And I think the number of webinars I attended at that time, I must have been available attending a webinar every day to understand what they are doing. And after all of this gauging and continuous meetings with the heads and all that, we finally ended up with a paid network to ensure that all 3,200 students were brought in into, you know, a very organized system and structure. So this tells me that every educator in this entire lockdown period has a story to share. People had made mistakes, but now from those mistakes, we learned how to avoid those mistakes. So this journey has been immensely appreciating. Until today, I count on those collaborations. Now, all this has given me very deeper sights on leadership. And that is that one has to be a continuous learner and contributor. If you have learned something, share it. You might feel people may know this or that, but the truth is, I can get something out of it. Because most of the time, people are scared of saying what they don't know. So I feel it's time that we create platforms where we share what we know, and this opens up areas of questioning and problem solving. A good question always promotes deep thinking and discussions, and that's what really supports us. I have learned immensely from this entire last year, and I thank all my fellow educators for really supporting my learning curve. Thank you so much.